245.
Money begins to make its mark everywhere. The sheikh gets millions. The soldier only a scrap. But it buys a new life for both of them.
302, sir. 302.
2-4 express. Maintain what?
Hunting trip, Zayed chases the desert game with a string of falcons as long as his purse. 20 years ago, he'd probably have gone hunting on foot with only a few birds to help him. Now he takes anything up to 100. Each of Zayed's followers has a falcon to look after. They train them, stroke them, talk to them, practically sleep with them. Like racehorses, they're the pampered darlings of a rich man's camp. And like racehorses, they cost big money. A good bird will fetch $600 or more imported from Syria or Iraq. And with so much oil money in Arabia now, the price is rising every year. Nothing escapes the touch of money. Money changes all relationships. When Zayed visits his neighbors now, the traditional feast for a visitor becomes an offering to a wealthy benefactor instead. Unlike many of Arabia's oil millionaires, Zayed believes in sharing his wealth. He told me once, the oil business is like a lottery. I might still be poor and my neighbors might be rich, so we ought to help each other. He's already given away millions. Zayed's host at this feast was one of his poorest neighbors. But now that Zayed has touched his palm with silver, he won't be quite so poor. The feast is traditional. Goat's meat, chicken and rice. And when the VIPs are finished, the lesser men move in. It's always the custom in Arabia for the poor to eat at the rich man's table, or rather, off the rich man's floor. When this lot have finished, there'll still be more to come, in descending order of rank and ascending order of hunger. It's not the most elegant spectacle, and it's not the choicest food, but in a harsh and hungry land, any excuse is welcome for a blowout, especially when it's held for a man with money.
قالي صفا ونزاح همي ولا باس إن قلت جرب لي القلم باهتمامه ما دام فكري سالي إن كله جاس بكتب معانا إن قلتها باهتمامه معنى على ما دار في القلب واحتاسنا.
The old Arabia pulls at the heart. The world where Zayed was raised, where he always likes to be. Around the campfire in the cool desert night, among his men, listening to those endless Arab fairy tales that the audience knows as well as the storyteller, of love and beauty and the thousand and one nights. When the hunting's over and the caravan's resting, this is how they've passed the time for a thousand years. This is the old and sometimes beautiful Arabia, where time is endless and patience more so. But in the new Arabia, time is money, and that pulls at the purse strings. This is the Arabia of the air-conditioned desert, the sanitized, sterilized caravan of the 20th century, with its international wealth and international access.
You can't play pool, let's play darts.
I play darts.
For these people, the old Arabia hardly exists. The mystery and the romance, or the harshness and the poverty, it's all one in the oil company's pay packet.
See you guys later.
To them, bye. Arabia is just another job. Tale is over, and everyone now will live happily ever after in the dream world of the Arabian Nights. But in the real world of Arabia tomorrow, it's not so easy. Not even Zayed's best friends can promise him a happy ending to his modern fairy tale that's only just begun. You can't reconcile the old life with $100 million a year, as his brother Shafwat learned. You can't even choose whether you'll have the old life or the new. God and the oil business have already chosen for you. From now on, you can only try to ride the terrible tiger of the 20th century and wonder if it will not eat you in the end.